Hello everyone, my name is Abel Kayode. Today I'm going to be showing you how to create contrasty black and white image in Photoshop. There are different ways to go about this, but I'm going to be showing you what I consider the best for dark skin tone. So without wasting much of your time, let's get into the video. Thank you very much, Naza, for letting us use your image. I really do appreciate it. I'm proud of you. Thank you so much. First and foremost, I want to create an adjustment layer. So let's go to black and white adjustment layer, reduce the opacity to, let's say, 25, then just burn the red a bit. Like so, then increase the yellow. I think I'm okay with it like this. Drag this and drop this here. Drag and drop this here, change the blending mode to overlay. And just brighten the highlight and everything. So I brighten the red, the highlight in the red, and I brighten the highlight in the yellow. When that is done, I'll go to my adjustment once again. Click gradient map. Click this side of the gradient map on the adjustment layer. Then click this particular gradient, black to white. And I say okay, so it's going to give us a fine black and white image. To further refine this, what I'm going to do is create another black and white adjustment. Also, set the blending mode to multiply. Then just reduce the opacity to what you think you're cool with. I think I'm cool with it about 40. Then let me burn the skin tone more. About 70 is okay. Then increase the yellow a bit to about 100 is okay. The particular one I posted on Instagram, I have red hair and red in our lips. How that is done is you just select all this adjustment, you group it, you create a max. Then select your brush, make sure your brush is on black and increase it to the highest. Then I zoom in so I can see exactly what I'm doing. Then I just paint on it. I just want only the red to show. So just go through where you know there's just red, and see the green is showing there. I can just press S to toggle between black and white. Press S to bring back what I want. Press S to just clean the edges and just select it more. I like the mixture of the black and red. I like how it looked burnt, so I'm not going to do anything to that. I'll leave it like that. Then to our lips also, I'm just going to paint around our lips. I'm okay with it like this. So I press and just zoom out. Now what I'll do is merge all the layer to a single layer. So I'll just press Shift Alt Command E on my keyboard. What that's going to do is going to merge everything that we've done and make it a single layer while still leaving our other adjustment, just in case we need to go back to refine it further. So I want to refine it further. So what I'll do is after merging it to a single layer, I'll go to Filter, Camera Raw. And there are different ways to add noise to your image. I want to add noise to this particular black and white image because I want to make it look a little bit vintage. And noise always give this cool real look to your image. It doesn't make it overly smooth. So to add this noise, you can do it in various ways, but the simplest way I think to do it is go to camera raw, then go to this tab, increase amount here like this. Here you can see the noise are coming out. You can reduce the roughness to something you think you're cool with. I think I'm cool with it at this place. Reduce it here. When that is done, I can just further refine my black and white. So I think it's a little bit too dark, so I just open the blacks a bit more, open the shadow a bit more, and just give it a little brightness, add clarity, then let's say go to sharpen, just sharpen it a bit, then here is just like the normal curves. Let's just play around, let's play around this button to see what it to do for us. I think I'm okay with it like this. Then click OK. Wow, so we have our our camera raw on this already. So all I want to do is to create this. I want to create this film look. I'm showing how to create this film look. This grainy kind of effect you see in pictures and movies. So there are two ways that I know. I don't know if you know more, please you can put it down in the comment section below. Then you go to selective color, reduce this to like 2, or let's uncheck this, create a new layer, go to edit, fill with 50% gray. Okay, okay, so I'll reduce this to like 5. So this is before, this is after. So if you're using this method, this is before, this is after. If you're using this method, before, this is my after. So I'm going to go with this. I like this method best. So to further refine this, what I want to do is I'll create another. I want to add some sort of vignette, so that I just want the focus to be on this part of the image more than it will be on this part of the image. Even though this is already dark, I just want to add a little bit of effect. So I'm going to fill this with black, reduce the opacity to till I'm okay with it, like 6% is okay. So I'm just going to go around her like this. Feather, let's feather like 300. Let's feather it one more time. Then click delete, just to delete this from this particular layer, so it can show what's underneath it. So this is before, this is after. So I just, to further refine it, I just want to run that camera raw filter on the black that I have, on this particular black. Just to further blending everything, that will help us blend everything together. That will help us blend it. We're adding a vignette, so let's just add the same noise that we've added to the image to that same vignette, so that they have the same filter run over them, so they will blend very well. I think the only thing left to this image is my logo. So let me drag and drop my logo. Drag and drop. And we have a fine contrasty black and white. And that's about it, guys. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please like. And if you don't enjoy the video, you can just say it in the comment section below. Say what you don't like so we can improve and all grow together. Thank you very much. Do share, do like, do turn off your notification bell so you can see more awesome videos like this. Thank you. See you in my next video.